Good evening. Good evening. It's still light and hot where I am. I don't know what the weather is like where you are, but it's hot in South Carolina. So good evening. Good evening. Giving time for some to come on tonight. We will, of course, not go over an hour, but I don't even think we're going to make it to an hour tonight, because we will go ahead next week and do part two of the discussion on tonight. But I am excited, trying to stay cool in this heat, and just so glad to be on tonight. And I'm giving some time to come on in. Come on in. I'm not seeing anyone in yet, but I know some are on their way. So I am excited on this Friday night just to be here. And tonight we're talking about the pain, the smile in front of the pain. And some will say the pain behind the smile is meaning and saying the same thing. But I am so excited. Let me know if you can hear me on tonight, making sure we're trying to go without any interruptions. But we are excited, and I thank you for your support, for all of you that have been attending and coming in. I am determined to help someone change their life. I'm motivated to help someone change their life and see things differently, because you are a priority, and I'm excited about that. And I'm excited that I've gotten great feedback about those that are making themselves a priority. And that's what it's all about. It's not about Faith Washington, but Faith Shares Real Wisdom. It's about you applying and making yourself a priority, making sure you're coming first, putting yourself on the top, not putting yourself on the bottom anymore, but making sure you're on the top. And that's what it's all about. A few announcements before I get started is that you can find us on YouTube by putting in Faith Washington. Faith Washington. You will see it's more than one, but I have my picture on there. Faith Washington, or you could put in Faith Shares Real Wisdom, and it should pop up. And I would appreciate if you would go ahead and subscribe to YouTube. And for our email, it's officialfaithshares@gmail.com. And on that email, you can put different topics you would like for me to share. And I say for us to share, because as we go on, I will be having different ones come to the platform and share. But we are starting. We're a babe in this. So let me start walking first, and then I'll bring you in. But there's some that are willing and bold enough to share, because this is what we want, to help others. And then you find out that you are not alone. No matter what the situation is, you're not the only person who went through, and you're not the only person who's going through something. So we want to do that. So I cannot see any chats on tonight or over there to see who's on, but I'm going to go ahead and start, because I cannot see anybody except for me. And that's a little different. So I'm the only person I can see at all. I have this other thing up, but yes, I'm looking. If you see me looking to the side, that was me looking at my daughter. But we're going to go ahead and start this discussion on tonight, the smile in front of the pain. the smile in front of the pain. And I know probably everybody that's watching or that will be watching the replay, the most of us can look at them and say, I have done it. I have done it. I have smiled no matter how I was hurting, because most of the time you can't share or tell anybody, because the community that most of us are used to, that's the one thing they don't want you to do is talk. But I need to tell you on tonight, a lot of times you can't heal without having that conversation, whether you face it yourself or you face it with someone else. But my thing is, for when I smile, my smile has to be real. I have smiled many a days and many a times and was filled with so much pain. Because you know how we would say, everybody don't have to know what you're going through. True, but I shouldn't have to fake it. I shouldn't have to walk around being somebody I'm not, being a person that's not happy and being able to express the pain or the hurt. Because sometimes the person you're looking at is the person that's causing the pain or have caused the pain. And a lot of times, you know, we say, forgive. And we forgive, but forgiving without a conversation is not the best thing always. I know that some people are saying, oh no, sometimes you got to face it dead on. Sometimes I need to tell that person, the one that caused so much pain, the pain that I'm feeling, or why or how I got there. Because sometimes somebody might not know, but in a lot of our cases, when I'm talking about real pain and deep pain, they know. Now, can I make them listen? No, I cannot. Can I make them understand how deep the pain goes, that they are the ones that have given me? Not always, because one of the things I have found out by going through so many things in life, unless you can admit, you know, you got to admit that there is pain. You got to admit that there is hurt. Because a lot of us, we are that place, you know, that pride sets in, and I don't want nobody to know that this really hurts me or whatever. I can give you a simple example of me growing up. A big size girl, red hair, was actually bright orange looked like, but of course they called it red. So carrot top, as one of my nicknames was, hair, light skin, freckles on the face, large size. So I was teased many of days. I was teased. I was ostracized. I mean, folks just, kids, even some adults made fun, and then someone said, oh, that's different. This is so cute. But the majority of the comments that I had were all painful. All of them were painful. But what did I do? I laughed it off. I always laughed about it. I act like it didn't bother me. And it really helped tear down my self-esteem. Already had issues not knowing that I should have them, but that really tore me down, because I still wanted friends, but you know, I was tall, always tall. So I'm being laughed at, talked about, and then everybody wants to play. And of course I'm playing because I want friends, but I went through so much pain as a child, and what a lot of folks didn't realize, even with that pain, I end up with a nerve condition, and my mother would take me to let the doctors, back then we just say you went to a doctor. Now I understand, and I am all for it. It was like a therapist, but at that time, that therapist didn't really help me. That same therapist insulted me right there in front of my mother. You know, he was like, oh, she got legs like the size of a horse and all this kind of stuff. And My mother would take me shopping to get boots, and I would get so upset and say, I don't want them. Because of what the doctor said, at that time, you had to go to a place like who sold hush puppies. Some of y'all can go back and remember back in the day, and they were not fashionable at all. Even in my day and time, they were not fashionable. They not came up a lot, but she would take me, and I would say, I don't want those. Because all I could hear in my head was, not only did this man say I had legs the size of a horse and I wasn't going to be able to get regular boots, I had to get the little short boots like the older ladies. It went along with people teasing and all this kind of stuff. And the funny thing about it, y'all know now being thick is popular. Not when I was a child. Not when I was a little girl. It was not popular. And to be that girl, always getting teased, I always hid it. I always kept it hidden. I did not share it size. Sometimes hitting people or putting me in fight mode or whatever when somebody would do it, because nobody knew how deep it was for me. And I would laugh and play it off and just be the joke, laugh at the joke, even though I was the joke. So many people do that even now. Now, you know, nobody said, you know, be careful how people say things, because usually they're meaning it. I didn't know that. So it actually set me up to keep looking for somebody that was gonna make me happy. And this started like as a child, and I realized it so much more of it later, how it began to affect me. That's why even with our kids, be mindful of what you say and what you say to them, because it goes in and their spirit, it feeds them. So I would yet smile, but I was always in pain, always hurting. But who's going to say, oh, if I were to tell them, okay, I don't like y'all teasing me, this and that, and blah, 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 who's going to pay me any attention? No, I just accepted it and kept smiling. We have the same thing in relationships. People are smiling, but they're hurting. They're in relationships that's not working, and nobody is willing to work it out. Or I can say it's one-sided, because you can have one person that's willing to work on it and the other person is not. It can't work like that. It's gonna take two. When we're talking about a relationship, let's say with a man and a woman, it takes both parties. Let's don't just say a man and a woman. Let's say a husband and a wife. It takes both parties. We were conditioned. We have been conditioned for years to hide the truth and live the lies. To hide the truth and live the lies. I know there are so many that will hear this and they can relate. We have been conditioned to hide the truth and live the lies. You're not happy, but you're smiling. It's so painful. Some people are just being emotionally abused, psychologically abused, and just smiling. Why? Because I don't want nobody to see the hurt. I'm one of them people, I see the hurt through the smile. I see so many ladies smiling down and laughing, and all I see is the pain. And nobody else will see the pain, and I usually pray for them because I can see the pain. Because I said before, we didn't learn anything else. I've said on an earlier episode, we have learned to be fake. But what about my true and real feelings? We have had things that happen in families, and you cannot live your truth because everybody wants you to bury your truth. If you're in pain, there should be someone that you can talk to help you heal, because you can never heal by just holding it. I'm going to tell you, you can never heal by just holding on to all of that, because it's destroying you, even with a smile. You're smiling, you put on your makeup, having a good time, so you say, doing all of this, but behind that smile is so much pain. It is so much pain. And with all that, I can't heal covering all this pain. I am one that do advocate for therapy, counseling. I do life counseling. I'm not a clinician. Otherwise, mine is life counseling. And I do all of that too. But the one thing I do, I be real with the people that I talk to. And I need them to be real with me, because we can't get anywhere, keep covering what's hurting us. And the majority of the time we know. But the part is, it's hard to get a two-way conversation. When it's a couple, we need to both talk about it. If it's something, I could say my husband now, if it's something he doesn't like or I don't like, we have to discuss it. It don't mean I'm gonna like it when we finish discussing it, but he gonna say his part and I'm gonna say my part, and then we can look. Because just like I look at things one way, he look at things another, we can come to a place and say, okay, because a lot of times you don't know how a person feels, and you cannot change how a person feels. But a lot of times that person does not see that you're seeing them that way until you explain. Because of this, I could say, well, that's not how I meant it, or I never even meant to bring it across that way. I would never know that if we don't have a discussion. He can never know if we don't have a discussion. So if it can be like, well, Faith, I got it like this, and I thought you were saying this and that. Well, I'm glad he said that so I can correct the action or make sure he knows how I meant it. I'm one of those people, I'm just straightforward, just right there, ain't hiding nothing, ain't keeping nothing, letting it all. So this way be like, okay, I took it this way, and it was not the way that I intended it. But see, you have to be to that place where you can communicate about it. Now, if it was the case where he's trying to tell me and I just be like, whatever, I don't care, he's letting me know he don't care. There's no other way for me to see it. Part of my healing is accepting that he don't care. You know, I'm having all this hope, but if he tells me he does not care, I can't get that mixed up. That was just plain English. He doesn't care. If I said I don't care, there's no other way to interpret it. Don't care. So that's a part. That's another part of healing. Accepting who somebody is in your life. You should not have to carry hurt and pain. And then when you get a chance to discuss it, and that person just lets you know, okay, well, that's all on you, Carolyn, and that's all on you, Debbie. It is, because now is my choice whether I want to be healed in this situation. That's one when we're talking about a couple. There are so many people, women and men, still carrying the hurt from things that happened to them when they were children. There are so many women that have been molested. Some have been raped as children. Men, same thing. They have either been molested or raped as children. And I know in a lot of the communities that we grew up in, that is taboo. That's like, you're quiet, especially because most of the time when those things happen, it's usually a family member. So you know how everybody protects the family, but nobody protects you. Nobody protects you, but everybody protect the family member. Because it was Uncle John, we don't want everybody to know that it was Uncle John that did it to you. So you carry that thing for years, and then you look at those people who cover for Uncle John, but nobody was there to protect and cover for you. Even when you could tell them from A to Z what took place, they still like, okay, but you just gonna keep this, and then you can't say anything. And then later on in life, you start talking and finding out you weren't the only one, but the family still covered. And everybody's still smiling and still at the reunions. That hurts. That's real pain. That is real pain. And in so many families, there is a, of course I won't call any names, but there is a man right now. If I was an evil person, but I'm not, I would just destroy his life for the things he have done to so many boys. So many. And nobody says anything. He still looks good. He still runs his church. He still does all it. Well, he has one now. He still do all his things. But when I found out that this man tried to, my brother is deceased, and he had some issues and some things happen, and he went to this for, well, he was directed to go to this person because he went to the head person, they directed. And this person took past advantage and really almost destroyed his life. And that's when he left. And those that know where I'm from, okay, we can say the state, yeah. Left Connecticut and went to California. But it was somebody who's supposed to be trusted. Everybody trusted because of their position. And if they ever see this, yes, I'm talking to you. And I'm like, wow. But of course, my brother would never tell me. My brothers would tell me. When the other one fight, they don't tell me anything because I'm that person coming straight for you. Not violently, by it. I can't even say it. I'm not coming in a rage. And maybe, sometimes. Now I wouldn't, of course, because it's over. But I will bring it back to your memory that what you done really affected someone's life. Literally cost them their good life. And people are walking around, but this is what happens when we cover up. Cover up. I am one. One of my passions and one of the things that if you want to see me upset, do something to a child. Do something to a child. It's going to have me totally won't be your best friend. And I'm going to say what I have to say. Because never, ever does anyone has the right to hurt a child. Never. It is never okay. Never okay for someone to molest or do any sexual act on a child. If you want to see all the sides of me, that's the one. I've been there, it's happened, and it's usually somebody that can be trusted. So you think. So I am all because in our community, a lot of times, it always goes, what did you do? How can you ask a child, what did you do? That's not even, what did a child do? Be a child? So, and you have so many adults right now still trying to get over, especially when it came to rape and molestation, still trying to get over that pain and that hurt because they can't talk to someone about that without them saying, listen, that was years ago, get over it. It didn't happen to you. So it's not just get over it. Yeah, they need someone that they can talk to. So someone that does understand so that they can heal. Because yes, you can heal. I am a witness and have that testimony. You can literally heal from that, but it doesn't come with just smiling and acting like it never happened. Because you have many adults to this day asking themselves, what did I do to deserve all that pain? And I'm here to tell you tonight, you did nothing. When this stuff happened to you as a child, it was not your fault. It was not your fault. And you're not the only one it has happened to. Not the only one. It has happened to so many. But of course, that's taboo in the community. You can't talk about that. Whether it was your cousin, your uncle, your daddy, whoever it was not your fault at all. That's a pain, a very deep pain that you can let go, even if you have to get help. I'm telling you, it can go. It can go. It can go. You can totally be healed. You don't have to keep carrying that pain. You are not the only one. Your family is not the only one that took up for some no good person that had a problem and kept doing it and doing it to so many. Yeah, that pain can go, but the majority of the time, you need help with it. Because when it keeps going back, you know, I know some of you understand this. You go so many years and all of a sudden it comes back fresh. And you now you're grown. You're an adult. You're no longer a child. But it was something that it did to your soul that just tore you apart. But you can't heal from that. You're not alone. And yes, they were wrong for covering for all these skeezers. Yes, they were. I keep using these old words, but it's okay, because I don't cuss. So these are just other words that's more appropriate. But just no good. And even on that, know that you can heal. Know that you can heal. And I do believe that we say you reap what you sow. They say what goes around comes back around. Oh, it will happen. And this is the part I can tell you how I healed, and I was healed. And it was funny because I prayed and my mother prayed. And my mother was a big, big part of my healing process. So I thank God, because my mother didn't know, because my memory just left me to the age 23 was when it came back. So do not walk around when people saying, I remember when I was 18 or when I was 19, it just came back. I used to say, that's a lie. How that's gonna happen? I used to be judgmental of people who would say, oh, I remember this happened to me such and such. And now, you know, they grow. I was like, oh, that's a lie, till it happened to me. And I was able, it was just like a video. I was able to say, everything that was in the room, the pajamas, everything. So listen, don't be judgmental, because you don't know what people are going through or what they have been through. And a lot of times it comes back at a certain time. So I thank God for this day. My mother was very, very instrumental in me in getting to a place where I was healed and was able to let go. And her birthday was yesterday, and she would have been 83 years old. And I miss my mother so much. I had that mother you could talk to about any and everything. Didn't try a lot of the times, because you just had to know her. She didn't play no games. But any and everything, I could go to my mother and have that conversation. So that was one of the things that bothered me. Why couldn't I remember? I was so traumatized that it took that part of my memory. So I am big on not letting your kids be up in everybody's house. I don't care if it's relatives. You got to know where they are. protect them at all costs. That part I just had to share, because there's so many women today still hurting from what happened to them. And people like to say, get over it. It didn't happen to you. So I guess ain't nothing for you to get over, because you ain't never been through it. So that's why it's easy to say, get over it. You know, be careful, because things that come to destroy your life, and that's what a lot of times that happened. But we're still here. We're soaring. We're helping other people. We will continue to help other people. That's one of my love for people, and big thing on protecting children, because I've been there, and it was not a place. Believe me, I had a mother that was very responsible, a mother that was very protective, and all this good stuff. But I need you to know, some of the people you think you can trust, not always. They don't come, as we like to say, they don't come looking like a devil with horns. A lot of them come dressed up, smiling, concerned, will do anything for you. So you have to be careful. But the smile again in front of the pain, the smile in front of the pain. We have another example, friendship, friends. I've talked to many who have had close friends. We say BFFs now, but people have had close friends, and they have stabbed them in their back. And my saying is, in your chest, right there in your heart. They don't even go for the back anymore. And they've done it thinking that you don't know. That's a hurtful thing. When the one or the two or three people you trust with so much of your life, you know how we do with sharing and all this stuff, and they turn, or they went behind you and they did some things. And now they're still in your presence like they did nothing. How do you deal with that? The person that you thought you could trust is the one who has stabbed you in your heart and your back, for those that want to stick to the back. And they're still with you because they don't even know that you know, acting like they didn't do anything, and you're still smiling. You are hurting. You don't trust them anymore, but yet, because you're not a priority, you still find yourself around these same people. Ask yourself, why am I hanging around these people who have betrayed me, who have stabbed me in my back, and I'm still smiling in their face? Everything, I believe, is going to go back to you being a priority. Because I'm going to tell you now, you're not going to be up in my face. I did that for years. I don't do that anymore. I don't fake nothing. Absolutely nothing. I do not, because that's a painful thing too. Is that's why when I say the smile in front of the pain, a lot of times people just think this relationship I have. Well, friendship is a relationship. If I say that's my girl, I expect that to be my girl. But when my girl has stabbed me in my heart and walked off like she ain't did nothing, because she didn't do it in front of me, she did it behind my back, and I'm still smiling, I gotta ask myself, so why? Why am I still gracing her with my presence? Why? What about me that makes it look, I got this saying, I will forgive you, but I'm gonna forgive you, apology accepted, but access denied. Part of that goes to my niece, because we would say it, no, apology accepted, but access denied. You will never, and I mean never, get that close to me again. You will think you're there, but you're not. You're not. Because once you become a priority, baby, I don't care if it was the dog catcher. You just not gonna let people, because see, that's how my smile ain't fake. Because I ain't even gonna let these fake people try to do this to me. You're gonna know, and I'm gonna speak to you, I speak to everybody. And I'm gonna love you. But I can love you, don't have to feed you. I need you to understand. Because y'all, you think you're caught up. When you are a priority, you will stop doing the things that cause you pain. Listen, you're going to stop doing those things that cause you pain. I don't have to put up with your stuff. I didn't have a problem with you. And you really didn't have a problem with me, but you wanted to get some gain on some stuff. So this is how you do it. Well, I'm that person that don't play games, period. Just don't. When you're a priority, let me tell you something. I'm going to help some of y'all tonight. Y'all stop this fake smile. You know how, because this is what we want to do. We want everybody to think everything is so great, this and that. Yeah, you ain't got to tell people all your business. But I tell you what, if you are part of the problem, if you are part of the pain, first of all, I'm going to let you know, we might can work this out. Now, we might can work it out because everything is not, you don't have to throw in the trash. Some things you can work out. Some relationships you can work out. There's marriages that you can work out. Because, see, back in the day, they ain't talk. They just went through all this stuff, did what they did, and hid it and act like everything was perfect. And then you'd be like, oh, my God, I didn't know they ever had any issues because they didn't talk. Now, you ain't got to tell all your business, but you need to let it be known. No. Things, I sound like my brother. No. But you things, we can discuss some things and work it out. If me and my daughter have a big falling out, well, they already know, you're going to really have to tell me something. Because first of all, I don't fall out with my kids. That's number one. Number two, ask me so that I can make it clear if that's exactly what I meant or that's what I said or all of that. Because see, that's a mother-daughter, mother-son relationship, grandkids or whatever. We gonna talk and we gonna go ahead and get this thing straight because we ain't walking around. Because I always say, no child I had or did or raised gonna walk around not speaking to me. I know y'all do that in a lot of families. It don't work over here. We not doing that. I don't have near a kid, I raise feed or anything else. They're gonna walk around talking about, I ain't talking to mama. Okay, evidently I ain't your mama. Because you gonna talk to me. You gonna speak to me and I'm gonna speak to you. Okay, we get all that clear. See, those kind of things ain't gonna be, we handle that. And see, in some families, that's what y'all need to do instead of all this fake business, fake stuff. There's some things you can work out. But now, like, I'm going to go back to if it's a wife and a husband. Y'all need to be able to work it out. But what will not happen? And because I can't see, my husband might be on here and he will tell you that this ain't no lie. I ain't making up nothing. I always tell my husband, and he feels the same way, but I always tell him because he's a pastor also. What you won't do is treat me all kind of way and get in front of church people and act like everything fine, because I'm going to be the first one to make the announcement. Oh, yeah. Always, and we laugh and we cut up, but I'm for real. I'm not going to have no fake marriage. I'm sorry. I will not. I refuse. So I said, I will not go through any type of abuse mentally. Definitely not physical. We'll do that. Save that for another time. If you go know me, you if you're a female and you go to our ministry, it's a thing we got going. Every man that meet me know how I feel about physical abuse when it comes to any of I say my females. But you're not gonna treat me all kind of way, and then I'm gonna make you look like King George in the public. No, 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 no. I see women do it every day. No, no, no. Somebody will say, some man say, don't y'all listen to her. You ain't got to listen. That's why you in so much pain right now. Because you listening to him. And they say, him that hurt you? Oh, no, no, no. We got to talk. If we can work this out, we going to work it out. But I'm going to tell you this. You are not going to abuse me mentally. You are not abuse me verbally. You're not going to abuse me, period. And then we go out and I make you look good. I am one. Yes, I am old school. I know you guys got all this different. You younger ones do y'all stuff different. But yes, I do believe this. If you're going to be the head of me, you're going to be the head of me. So I'm not going to break my neck trying to pay a bunch of bills and you laying around. We got kids, you're going to feed them. Oh, that's what you're going to do. We're going to take care of the family. So, you know, y'all like to give kingship to those that's not even prince. Love to give kingship to those that's not even a prince. They don't even do the things a prince would do. No. No. Let me help somebody. When you smile and you behind him, you behind him. And he's doing you right. Why? Because you a priority. Yes, you gonna hear me say all the time, because when you a priority, these things are not gonna be that issue. But what you won't do is treat me all kind of way, and I got you looking like, yeah, all kind of kingship. The whole community think you grand, you this, you that. Oh, yeah, that's a good man. But he ain't doing nothing for his wife. He ain't doing nothing for his kids. And y'all know who fault that is? I'll let y'all guess. I'm going to let y'all guess. No. Because guess what? It's funny to me, and I'm talking about so many women, so many, that I'm watching and that I'm talking to do this, but then when I ask them, what is that man doing for you? Just like I can't hear your answer, they don't have one. Because I'm going to have you looking like this king, and you have me looking like a little peasant? No. This is real. This is real. The smile in front of the pain. You are suffering day in and day out. Literally suffering with pain, and they don't even have enough respect to even want to try to work it out. Some things, I'm going to tell y'all, it does evolve, and I'm going to say, I pray all day, pray all night. But sometimes you do need, really, to talk to a therapist, especially because I am not one that say, oh, throw your marriage in the trash unless it need to be thrown, because there are times that it do. You know, I did this thing all these years and they ain't doing no different. Okay, no, I'm not the one to talk to, because I'm going to tell you, they not showed you who they were for 20 years. Come on now. How much more do you want? They not showed you who they were for 40 years. I know somebody was married 51 years and walk up on their wife and say, I don't want to be married no more. 51 years? What you got to do? 51 years, and then you're going to tell me you are, and I done gave you the best of 51 years, and now you don't want to be married to me? Well, y'all know that answer. We ain't even need to see nobody for that. 51 years, you gonna wait the 51 years, as we would say, of my life? And that's my young life. Now you wait till we getting older. I wish my husband might. I'm laughing. He's not gonna do that. But I'm just saying, I wish he would. No, you should have knew that in year 3 or 4. So you gave me a chance to, hey, let somebody else celebrate me and me celebrate them. Keep it real now. Don't have me giving all my life to you And then you decide. You don't just wake up talking about you don't want to be married no more. This, baby, somebody not came and caught your eye, whatever they did, and you not playing your way out. But you got to make sure I'm going to let you out. That we got to make sure that you're going to be looking the same when you leave. Because if you leave, something ain't going to be quite the same. I'm just saying. Well, you don't have to carry this pain. You do not have to keep going through day in, day out. I mean, we have all different types of things. We smile. A lot of folks not happy. Ask yourself, why am I not happy? Am I depending on somebody else to make me happy? Because usually that's the number one problem. We are depending on someone else to make us happy. Mm-hmm. That's a big issue. I'm going to give you that as one of the answers. You are depending on somebody else to make you happy. You're depending on somebody else to make you smile. You're depending on someone else to make your day. I got news for you. You need to be happy if you're by yourself. You don't stop trying to find happiness in a person or a thing and find happiness in yourself. And they need to have happiness within them so you can enjoy each other. See, I don't come bashing. I come to help. I come to motivate. I am determined that a whole lot of us been living life like hell and we ain't gonna keep doing this. A whole lot of us don't even think we can be happy. And I'm here to tell you, yes, you can. It starts with you, baby. It starts with you. It starts with you. It doesn't start with somebody else coming in your face and grinning and doing all this. You think all of those are the little band-aids. It starts with you. Real happiness starts inside of you. Nobody was telling you. I'm here to tell you. It starts with you. You can have a husband and 5 kids. It still starts with you. You still have to be that priority. You needed to be that priority before you had that husband and that kids. And some of us got to the place and we didn't learn it till later, but we thank God we got it. Glad we got it. And we moving on and we making sure not only do I don't wait on you to celebrate me, I celebrate myself. Because I'm telling you tonight, and I'm going to be stopping in a few minutes, I'm telling you tonight, honey, I've been there, and I will share a lot of things, but I'm going to tell you, not being happy, not having self-esteem, not having confidence, not knowing who I was, staying full of pain, always crying because not feeling needed or wanted or good enough, caused me to take a turn in my life that I would have never saw coming. But because I couldn't deal with it, I went to other things. And I had I have a sister friend, and because I can't see, she might not be on here tonight. And it was something she asked me when she was telling me she was glad to see what I was doing. But who encouraged you or gave you your first hit? And when I said it, I was thinking of where I was in life then, full of pain. And I'm here to tell y'all, and I'm a witness to this, and I don't hide my past. I help with my past. I help people with my past. Because yes, my whole life changed, and my whole life has been changed. And yes, I'm happy, but I wasn't always this person. Alcohol is not going to cover up that pain. Drugs is not going to take away that pain. Let me be real. Some of us who turned to drugs, and while we was doing the drugs, we talking about it like it's not, we did. That's when we took the time to pour it all out, what all was going on, how you was being hurt, how you wasn't good enough, this and that. And we had a crew that it ain't even funny, because we grew up in the church, we started talking about the Bible, and the Bible say this, all this while you getting high now. Drinking. You drink yourself till you fall out, the whole room spinning, your head back, you're doing all this stuff, trying to more expensive liquors, and not just then the hard liquor. And it does nothing but keep you in that little moment to make you forget, according to what drug you was doing, it brought it more clearer. But keep you in that moment, and then you passing out. Because somebody be like, oh, have a drink. Girl, don't worry about it no more. It's going to go. When you wake up, honey, that same pain before you took that drink, before you took that hit, before you, it's still there. It did not leave. The liquor ain't going to heal you. The drugs ain't going to heal you. I don't care how good they say it is. It can be cut, uncut. The most expensive liquor, popping all your, it does not take away the pain. It does not take away the pain. I know it sounds like, okay, Faith, your voice is getting elevated. Yeah, because I've been there. It does not take away the pain. Actually, it prolongs it because you will not face your true reality. It doesn't take away the pain. You can drink 24/7 and you can't drink 24/7 because you got to fall out, find something to eat, get back together. Get it back together to start all over again. And I don't care how many times you start, when you come to, that pain is still there if you're not going to deal with it. You got to deal with the actual pain and the thing that is hurting you, the thing that is destroying you. Don't depend on someone else to be your answer. Don't do it, baby. You're wasting too much time. Don't depend on somebody else to bring you all the answers. Start telling yourself the truth. Go back to that mirror, look at yourself, and say, Faith, why are you hurting? Why are you alone in this? Why are you letting this thing keep going on? You have the power to fix it. And that's the thing. The whole time, you think you don't have the power because when this stuff comes, it comes to make you feel powerless. You have the power. You are the person. Because let me tell you something. With all the prayer, if you believe in prayer like I do, all the prayer, it still will not help until you decide, I don't want this anymore. I don't want this feeling anymore. I will not go another day, stay in the same place of feeling powerless, not another day. Because I'm a priority, it's time for this pain to leave, and it's time for me to heal. It's time for me to enjoy my life. It's time for me to smile. And ain't no fakeness behind it. It's that time. It's time for you to enjoy your life, not wait on somebody for you to have a life. It's time for you to enjoy your life and not wait on somebody for you to have a life. Because until, I'm going to keep saying it, until you become a priority, there's going to always be a whole lot of issues. I'm happy with my marriage because ain't nothing fake around here. If it's something I don't like, my husband will tell you, I'll say it. Ain't that he going to agree with everything I say, but I don't have to hide stuff. I don't have to feel this way. I tell you what, we together because why? He know how to treat me. I know how to treat him because what I won't do is stay in something that's killing me. What I won't do is wish for something that's killing me to stay in my life. And I know that's a hard one, but somebody need to hear it. The thing that's taking you out, you praying for it to stay. Isn't it funny? I don't know who you believe in, but you ask God for something, you ask God to show me, and then when he shows you, you close your eyes. Wow. You ask him to show you, and then when he shows you, you close your eyes. Why? Because you want to still keep that pain and walk around with that fake smile. I want y'all, let me tell you, y'all too beautiful or handsome, whichever one, because I don't want y'all to think I'm just all about women. I'm mostly about women, but I love men also, and I'm not biased. I know a lot of great young men. I know a lot of great young men that don't have it all together, that I'm praying they get it together fast, and some of them that can, because they didn't have anybody to show them. Because why? People act like, and men act like men don't hurt. And when they hurt, it breaks cold if you show it. I just helped somebody. Men think it breaks cold if you show that you're hurt. It breaks cold if you show that you need healing. Listen, don't be so hard as a man. When you know you need healing, it's not wrong with saying you need healing. And you're not a punk, because sometimes you have to shed tears. But you need to get, you need to be that man that loves himself and then will love that woman. Let me take it to in our part, like Christ loved the church. That's what we say over here. But just that, would treat that woman like she really is a queen. Be that king and wear that crown. Just don't be sticking up that crown like it's just crown royal. So when you put too much in, you falling out all over the place, don't even know where, it ain't nothing in the bottle to put back in the bag. Oh yeah, know all of that. But I'm saying, I just want you to know, that's not gonna take away the pain. The alcohol ain't gonna take away the pain or the problem. The drugs ain't gonna take away the pain or the problem. You have to want to be healed. I want your smile to be real, like real. Like, honey, when you smile, you feel it. Like this man told me today, Miss, I wasn't smiling because it's hot. Y'all, it's hot here in South Carolina. And he said, ma'am, I was an old Caucasian man. He said, ma'am, you might need to put a smile on your face, because if you don't smile, that makes it look like you broke. And I was leaning over the basket, and you got to know me to know me. I stood up and said, well, let me tell you something. I ain't broke. I didn't say I'm not broke. I said, I ain't broke. So we ain't gonna, he said, oh, what you say? I said, I ain't broke. So what we not gonna do today, while I'm in this line, is look at me and look at this black woman and talk about, because she ain't smiling, she broke. But I said, I got myself together, because I was like, no, you're not gonna do that to me. Look at me and just say I'm broke because you were just talking to somebody else that was your color. Don't do that. No. And they're gonna look at me. We not gonna do that. I'll let you know in a minute. No. See, I know who I am. You gotta know who you are. You're not gonna let people just put stuff on you. Yes. Back to, I want your smile to be real. I want you to enjoy. Because some of us have been suffering so long, we just think, hey, just live with it. No. Live and be happy for real. I don't have to live with somebody else's issues. It's up to them to get it straight. The problem is you trying to be there for everybody else and not there for yourself. Faye, what do you need to do to be healed? How can I change? What do I want? Where do I see myself? I'm not too old to have fun. I'm going to have fun. In my 60s, in my 70s, I'm going to have a great time. Why? Because I love me. I'm not trying to stare death in the face. Y'all need to live. Be around people who want to live, who's talking about really living. Okay? That's what you need to do. Mind what people are putting in your ear, that's going to your mind, and then you start thinking, well, no. When someone is telling you a bunch of negative stuff, that ain't the person you want around you. I don't care if it's a family member. If all they got to say is negativity, love them, but call them. So every once in a while. Cut that off. You want positive things. I'm going to stop for the night because I see it's 59 minutes and 31 seconds, and I do not want to go over an hour. I love you guys. Again, you can go to Faith Washington on YouTube, or Faith Shares Real Wisdom is all on YouTube. And click and subscribe, please. Hopefully next week we will be on StreamYard, because I'll be saying Yard Stream, StreamYard, and on YouTube at the same time. I love you. Peace. Put that smile on, but just don't put it on. Let's do the work so we can smile for real. I love y'all. Have a good night.